Welcome back to the trail with Mushy the Cowboy Cook. Today we're going to do some fajitas, just like we did the other week at Benson Mule Days. And then I'm going to show a little footage of kids on horseback as they were introduced to a program that started this past summer down there in Benson at the rodeo. Let's get into the video. Now for my fajitas, what we did at the show was we actually just pan fried it. But back home, back on the ranch, I wanted to turn it up a little bit. So what I'm going to do is put it in a basket, has holes in it to flame kiss it. And I've got a red, yellow, and orange pepper. And I've got a small onion in there. All the peppers are probably 2 inches long. Try to cut them all about the same size. The onions, fairly good sized pieces, just so they don't fall through the basket or anything. I'm just going to cook these up. These probably take 15 minutes or so. You can do this on your grill. Obviously, you can do it inside on a pan. But why not do it out on the grill? And then also with football and all the tailgating going on, why don't you do this on your grill? If you're grilling at your tailgate parties, do it there. Because all you do is gonna cook the onions with the peppers, and then I'll put the meat on and cook that up. So we'll come back after this is cooked, and then we'll get started on the meat. All right, these are almost done, probably another 3 or 4 minutes. Two quick tips. With this basket, cooking over wood, you don't obviously have even heat. So I keep moving the basket around, plus the food around. And then another pro quick tip is I didn't put any seasoning on this. The meat is seasoned. We'll talk about that when we get to it. But depending on if you don't know who you're cooking for, or depending on who you are cooking for, I've always gone light on the seasoning and the hotness of it. I prefer to cook it more mild and then let people add more seasoning or to spice it up if they want to. That way you don't have people complaining about how hot it is and not eating it. You want everybody to be happy with it. And you can always make it hotter. You just can't take the hot out or the spiciness out. So keep that in mind when you're cooking, especially if you're cooking for people you don't know what their preferences are. Now this steak was already in a marinade for fajitas, so I didn't add any more seasoning to it. I may on mine when I get mine done, make mine up later on. As for me, I'm cooking some for my mother, so she doesn't like a lot of spicy or hot things, so I keep it fairly mild. If you don't buy marinated meat, well, typically a fajita is either skirt, flank, sirloin, but you really can use whatever you want. I prefer to use sirloin. This package did not say which cut of meat it was, but typically it's one of those three or the most common ones. And then got some flame going, so it's gonna be all flame kissed up. Now obviously, depending on how hot it is, how much flame you got as to how long it will take to cook the meat. But normally 4 or 5 minutes. So we'll come back once that's done. Alright, the meat is done. You hear that sizzle. Mix that in with the vegetables a little bit. Now what I'm going to do is just got some sour cream and a flour tortilla. And as I make it up, talk to you about this these kids at the rodeo. One lady's in charge was telling me they started a school for kids to learn how to do rodeo. Obviously not riding bulls, but riding the horses, barrel racing, cap roping, and things like that. They had 70 kids to go through this summer. And I'm sure they're going to be doing a few things here through the school year and then start back up next summer. And she's thinking they'll have even more. Well, I think that's great because, for one, rodeo activity, the sport of rodeos, it's a young person sport. And so it's kind of like football and baseball. You only have so many years you can actually participate, then you just get too old. But it's a very traditional sport that I'm happy that somebody is trying to get kids involved and get their interest up to continue on the tradition of the rodeo sport. Now this was the first rodeo we've ever participated in. We actually catered to a cattle group down there, cattle ranch. And we had a great time. We didn't know really what to expect on everything, but the people were super nice. We really enjoyed hanging around them whenever they weren't performing and doing their thing. I'm pretty sure we're going to go back next year and do the same thing. But the other shows we go to have a lot of old tractors and things like sawmills, tobacco barns, real traditional things that we need to get the kids interested in that. These old tractors from like pre-World War II, you know, their grandparents are getting a point where they aren't even around. But hopefully the kids over time will get interested in these tractors and a sawmill, a water-powered grist mill, things like that. So I'm always happy to see younger folks starting to participate. And I actually do at most of these shows will see I'll say kid, teenager. There's one boy we've gone to several shows that I think he's around 10. He is fascinated with antiques. He's got several tractors and some other antiques. Met a boy this weekend and the weekend, Labor Day weekend he was at, helping run the sawmill. So that's one reason why I'm trying to show these shows we go to and what we do out there, so that maybe you'll come out, maybe your kids get interested, maybe you'll get interested in some of these traditional activities. All right, let me make this up right quick. So that I'm going to put a little bit of sour cream on mine. One thing, you can always add garlic, you can do mushrooms, whatever you like. And that's, like I said before, on all my recipes. Do it to where your fits your taste. The meat is, like I said, it was already pre-seasoned. You really taste that. You can taste some of the charring from the vegetables and the meat being flame grilled. Definitely worth trying, whether it's in your backyard, on your grill, over a fire. If you go tailgating, camping, definitely do it over your grill or a fire, whatever the case may be. And if you can't do any of that, do it in a frying pan in the house. But again, I want to encourage you to come in your backyard and try some of these recipes. And as we go down the trail, we're going to do some other recipes that you can easily do in your backyard. And hopefully that will get you outdoors cooking.
She got cut with a sword in Chancellorsville. And she got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Beauregard, and Bragg.
We have over 70 members, all from Benson and local surrounding areas, and this is our first year. You've got your greedy goat tires, your dummy ropers, the fast barrel racers and pole benders, and the rank and rowdy mutton busters. You can watch these boys and girls compete in their finals rodeo right here in this arena on Sunday at 2 o'clock. Our mission in the BBJRA is introducing our youth to the sport of...
They said, boys, let's go roping. Come on, let's get some heels. Get out of that face up here. Let's go. Hey, what are you saying? So 65. Now it's time to beat the down team roping. Let's look to your next team to work. Going back to Rock Hill, South Carolina. Your number 17 man in the stadium. Well, look at Wyatt Reed on the head. Hey.
This guy was so excited about partying, he ran off and forgot his shirt.
We'll get them back in and ready to go.
One more thing about these shows that we go to, the Benson Mule Days has been going on for over 70 years. One man there had been to every single one. I think he's 82 or so. So he was just a little kid when he went to the very first one they had. October 8th, we're going to be at the Goldston Old Fashioned Day. That's going to be their 34th year. The show we go to in Labor Day weekend in Silcope, I think that's 40 some years it's been going on. So a lot of these shows have been going on for a couple of generations. And obviously there are kids that are coming on up, but you see a lot of older people there. And we need youth to come into these shows and, you know, whether to get start liking these tractors, the sawmills, things like that. You don't have to own anything. Just to be interested in like a sawmill, things like that, the tobacco barn. Start helping out here and there. And then take over when these old-timers want to kick back and retire from doing it every year. So that's my rant for the shows. We enjoy going to them, and we hope we'll be going to them for years on end. We've made a lot of friends. I personally made a lot of really good friends at these shows that I enjoy seeing every time we go, and I meet new ones all the time. So if you are in the Goldston area, which is again just south of Siler City, North Carolina, on off of 421, it's easy to get to. Come out and see us, say hello, watch us what we do, come around the wagon, meet myself as well as Mosey. He's going to be there. We'll have one wagon there that day. But come on out. In the meantime, if you like videos like this, please hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. Share it with a friend. Like it. Ring the bell. And Mushy, the cowboy cook, will see you down the trail.